Mbabazi Irene realized that her kidney could no longer support her body after she noticed she was swelling and sweating for a long time. At first, she sought care and assistance from herbalists, but nothing seemed to work until she sought help from a professional doctor. After all tests were done, it was revealed that Mbabazi was to be on dialysis for the rest of her life. Mbabazi spends around 300,000 shillings every week for her two dialysis visits at Mulago.
Okay, I realized like I was working somewhere and my body was swelling. So I didn't know because I thought maybe I'm becoming fat. So I went somewhere like herbal, these people who have herbal pharmacies. Yeah. So when I went there, the doctor checked me, herbalist. He told me, yeah, you are sick, your kidney is not fine, your things inside are not fine. He gave me some medicine, then I came back home. But the things were getting worse. Then my brother told me to go somewhere in Kamocha and see some doctor there.
Just like Irene, Ferry Balira had kidney failure after suffering from COVID-19. She spends between 350,000 to 500,000 shillings per visit.
But then I got COVID. It destroyed my kidneys. That's why I'm here. I come on Tuesday and Fridays. It takes 4 hours. I feel okay.
According to Dr. Kaliesubula Robert, the President Uganda Kidney Foundation and a consultant nephrologist from Makerere University, Uganda has about 450 people on dialysis, both in government and private hospitals.
Dialysis is a process of cleaning the blood of toxins. Actually, the dialysis is an artificial kidney, which takes over the roles of the kidneys. So in order for people to go to dialysis, there are two occasions. One is called acute kidney injury, when we expect the kidney to recover. For instance, someone gets an accident, or someone is delivering and they lose a lot of blood, or someone has an acute infection. There, the kidney gets paralyzed for a little while. We talk about it 24 to 7 days. Then those people can do acute dialysis. When they do acute dialysis, the kidney can recover.
If a person's kidney totally fails, one has to be on dialysis for the rest of their lives unless a kidney transplant is done, as Dr. Kaliesubula explains.
Chronic kidney failure. Now, for such patients, it means that all efforts have been undertaken and the kidney has failed to work. And so then dialysis becomes a replacement of the kidney to help it, to help the person to live, actually. Because if those people don't do dialysis, they would actually die. So that artificial kidney, which is dialysis, now helps to take over the role of the kidney and helps them. So these people need dialysis for life.
Mulago Hospital has 25 specialized dialysis beds, according to Elson Tibaingana, an in-charge at Mulago.
Currently, we have about 120 patients that come to the unit. The day you come for dialysis is counted a session. So we charge per session. And in Mulago Hospital, it's a cost-sharing service, whereby the patient brings money and the hospital also, the government also caters for some percentage. So currently, patients pay a cost sharing of 150,000 per session. That is for dialysis only.
Basereka Thompson, a kidney specialist nurse at BHL Kidney Care Center in Kololo, advises kidney patients on what and what not to eat while on dialysis.
When your kidneys fail, they are not able to eliminate the toxic substances adequately. And some of these toxic substances can come from the foods we eat. So there are so many foods that will restrict, that generate too much toxins in the body. So for example, we try to tell them to limit the animal proteins, especially the red meat, because that one generates a lot of urea and creatinine. We try to advise our patients to limit the potassium-containing foods like fruits, grains, and vegetables. We tell them to eat more of posho, more of cassava, rice, yams, things like that.
He also advises kidney patients to be careful on where to get dialysis services, because sometimes one's body system may not work with a machine, hence causing death.
There are some instances where a patient can get complications the machine and passes on. Because remember, we are getting the patient's blood outside the body. That alone itself, getting the patient's blood outside the body, you must be having enough blood, first of all. So if a patient is not having enough blood and we connect the patient on the machine, then they can get complications. One, the pressures must be well controlled, because we are removing the patient's blood from the body and we are circulating it outside the body. So for you to make sure that your patient is comfortable, you make sure that the blood pressures are stable. The patient himself must be also stable.
Dr. Jagenda Joseph Ogavu, a kidney specialist from Nsambya Hospital, emphasizes on the effectiveness of dialysis and its life expectancy.
So you run it through that, and then the waste products are removed, and then the cleaner blood is returned to the patient's system. And that needs to be done a good number of times a week, minimum 3 times recommended. Yes, otherwise in good settings, dialysis is offered for shorter durations of time, say 2.5 hours, for up to 5 times a week, because one is supposed to get a total of at least about 12 hours of dialysis in a week. I can give you answers from Uganda. We have someone that has been on dialysis for 15 years. There is someone in India that has been on dialysis for 45 years. And I think I've heard of someone that is 50 plus years. However, most people do not survive long on dialysis. They don't survive longer than 5 years. So
it varies. The longest I saw a person who had been on dialysis was actually when I was doing my studies at Yale. We found a patient who had been on dialysis for 30 years.
We have in Mulago patients who have been on dialysis for 13 years, 12 years.
Yeah.
Yes.
Dr. Kalie Sobula says, despite being on dialysis, one can live a normal life.
The commonest cause of kidney disease in the world is actually diabetes, high blood sugar, and high blood pressure. The dialysis doesn't solve those two. So you still have to take your high blood pressure medicines, you still have to take your antidiabetics. And for instance, if you had another problem like an infection, maybe HIV that caused you to have the kidney problem, you will still need to take those drugs. Which daily living activities can one carry out? Of course, they can continue to play football, they can play soccer, but swimming is a bit tricky, particularly if you've seen a catheter. So that catheter can easily get infected, so these persons might not be able to swim. But doing other things, having children, that's okay. Although sometimes it's hard because the kidney might not allow you to get pregnant if you have kidney failure. But if you are able to, it gets very difficult. We've actually had some people who have tried to conceive on dialysis, and it got very difficult. They actually lost several of the pregnancies. But yes, the activities of pleasure, like having sex, those are very welcome. You can continue to have fun.
All the 4 specialists advise that in order not to reach this situation, people should be mindful of high blood pressure and diabetes, because they are the leading cause of kidney failure. They suggest body monitoring through medical checkups. According to research, 6% of Ugandans above 18 years have kidney diseases, with the age of 30 to 70 years mostly affected. However, this does not contribute to the number of kidney specialists in Uganda, which only has 13. Report compiled by John Musenze for the news.